A graphic of the Perkins logo swoops across the screen, revealing a chapter heading. Working with physical and occupational therapists.
I'd say 80 or 90% of the students that I've worked with that had power chairs or scooters, it was just dropped off by a salesman. And they received no real training on how to navigate doorways, how to cross streets, making sure that they're safe on the sidewalks. Usually the delivery man just brings it by, plops it down. This is how you turn it on. This is how you go forward. This is how you go backwards. And this is how you charge it. If a student hasn't had an assessment from PT or OT, they should probably get one, because that PT or OT may be able to help you get them out of the chair.
Pop, 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 pop. Good job.
In a video clip, a young boy in a wheelchair is working with a physical therapist. She assists him in moving from the chair to a standing position and then transitioning to a seated position on a nearby bed.
It's nice that we're teaching them how to use the chair, but it's even better if we can take somebody who needed the chair all the time and we get them to where they don't need it all the time. And the PTs and OTs can help with that. They can give them the kind of assignments or exercises to do that may help them build up their strength. Another good example is, I worked with a PT one time with a student who had a spinal cord injury. And I was expecting the woman to be able to reach forward, grab a door, pull it open, or to be able to reach out and touch something on the counter and come back. But when I went to the PT with one of her appointments, the PT was able to explain to me that because of where the injury was, the woman had no trunk control. So once her body went beyond the balance point, she had no way to get it back up unless she let go of what she was doing and pushed it back up with her arms. That's something that they're going to know. That's their specialty. O&M instructors aren't going to know that stuff. And it can be very valuable in making somebody be as successful as they can. And it helps keep us from having expectations that the client really can't meet because of something physical, not just because they don't choose to or don't want to.
In a video clip, we see the same young boy and the physical therapist. With some assistance from the therapist, the boy makes his way from the bed back into his wheelchair.
My advice is to, if you get somebody in a wheelchair, go with them to some PT sessions. If they're not receiving PT or OT at the time, try and get it set up to where you can at least just go do one meet and consult with them, if not more. A lot of the stuff that I've developed working with people, when I've taken it then to the PTs and shown them, hey, look at this cool thing we're doing, they've been able to say, oh, well, here, I can make it better this way. So going to PTs and OT, they're just going to take what we do, make it better. It's going to help protect us so that we're not taking somebody beyond their abilities. And the big thing is, we don't want to get anybody hurt. Try to help, but at least don't harm them. So going to the PTs and OTs just helps make sure that you don't do that.
Fade to black.